Welcome to each and every one of you. Welcome to our viewers and our listeners. It is so nice to have you here today. There's been a lot of work gone into this time of worship, and I'm so appreciative of all of it, and particularly for our director, Tanyce, who has assembled this fine orchestra, as well as worked her best with the choir. We do our best, and that's all we can do, but we're very grateful to be a part of this. So thank you, Tanyce, for your hard work. And for Alan, getting you out of the organ bench is really cool. That doesn't happen very often, so it's good that that can happen too. A couple of things, Advent Bible study continues this evening at 7 o'clock, and you may notice in the bulletin there is an event called the Youth Drive-By Giving, and that is in the bulletin and details are there, but it's an event in which we all can participate, and wouldn't it be awesome if all of us did? Then next Friday there will be a lock-in for our students, 8th to 12th grade, here at the church, of course. And also, a few service notes, the yellow slips will be collected with the offering plates today. We'll not have a special prayer, so they will be collected in the offering plate, so the ushers will not come around to you separately. And also, we're going to receive our Holy Communion by intinction today. And you may recall that simply taking a wafer and dipping the wafer in the wine for the body and blood of Christ. Just a real quick primer on that. Wait till you're prompted by the ushers to come. And you will come down the main aisle, except for those in the wing, and we will commune you separately before that all starts. You'll be prompted by the ushers. You'll come down the main aisle, and you will go to the left or right, depending on where you're sitting in the sanctuary. And at the end of the communion rails will be two communion stations. So you come down there, get a wafer, dip it in the wine. It's that easy. It really is. Thing is that sometimes, you know, we're used to the older way of doing it. We may take the wafer and put it in our mouth right away. Do not take it out of your mouth. I know it sounds silly, but you kind of, you don't know today. We'll give you a fresh wafer. Don't worry about that. And if you drop it in the wine, don't go fishing for it either. So we'll give you a fresh wafer at that point if we need to. Do not worry. Just come forth in the peace of Christ, which is what all of this is about. Come forward in the peace of Christ to receive the Holy Communion. At this time, I have one more announcement, but I would ask Linda, can you give us a temple talk?
I'll try. Good morning. I'm Linda Hoch from the Board of Spiritual Life. There is a tree in the far left corner of the gathering space. On it are envelopes with names on them. One envelope for each confirmation student. I ask you to prayerfully consider taking an envelope and becoming that young person's prayer partner for the next year. Imagine their surprise when they receive a note from you. How wonderful it is to know that someone from Emanuel is praying for you, encouraging you in your faith walk. You expect that from your pastors, your confirmation teachers, and your family. But it is special when someone else lets you know that they care about your spiritual growth. Young people need our prayers, our support, encouragement, and celebration of their efforts and accomplishments. Thank you.
Thank you, Linda. Very good cause to be prayer partners together. How powerful and important. My last announcement, also a service note, but I think it's an important service note for all of us. Tanyce decided to change things on me because she likes to see me sweat. We're making a very intentional change based upon the events in Connecticut. At the end of the service, we were going to sing one song, and so Darlene, you got it right, but we're changing that. And we're going to change it to Let There Be Peace on Earth. Words will not be in your bulletin. They will be flashed on the screen. And in light of what's been going on around here, I think we need a prayer. So let us bow our heads. God, our hope, in you the light shines in the darkness, and morning turns to joy. Be with the community of Newtown, Connecticut, in this time of overwhelming sorrow. May your light surround them, and may your love and support be known to all the victims of violence, wherever they may be. We pray all of this in your deep and holy name. Amen. We continue with the lighting of the Advent wreath. Thank you.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lowly exile here until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Today is the third Sunday of Advent, the Sunday of joy.
Our joy is in God and in his Son, Jesus Christ. Like peace, joy is a gift from God. It overtakes us and fills us when we remember what God has done and what he has done promised to us.
We light this candle today to remind us that Christ came and in coming so that all people might have a rich and abundant life. We thank God for the hope that he gives us, for the peace that he bestows, and for the joy he pours into our hearts.
Let us pray. O God of joy, Emmanuel, send your light into our hearts at this time. Help us to be ready for the time of Christ's appearing. Fix our hearts and our minds upon those things you have done and for those you have promised to do, that we may have the joy you have promised. As we worship you, strengthen us so that we may always do your will, and so bless you and the world you have made. Amen.
Children could be dismissed for children's church. And while that is going on, I would like to just bring a few announcements. We've had some sickness and some replacements in our orchestra, and we so appreciate all of the talent that is our guest to us today at Emmanuel. David Yee, Kate Stoneburner, Sean Tyler, Haley Palm, Luke Hunley all have special parts and solos, as well as some many guests in our choirs today. As we offer our cantata today, may our music open your hearts and minds and make each of us instruments of peace. Ladies and gentlemen, the Emmanuel Choir and our cantata. Thank you.
In the beginning was the Word. The Word, holy, sacred, just, eternal. God in Christ, Christ in God. In the beginning, and suddenly, the Word was flesh, incarnate, human, breakable, common, morning light into darkness. And that lifelike blazed out of the darkness. And the darkness could not put it out. Redeemer, Savior, Messiah, Lord. His name? Jesus. He became human and lived among us. We saw his glory, the glory that belongs to only the Son of the Father. And he was full of grace and truth. Now awake, O sleeper, arise from the dead. The Messiah will shine upon you. This baby in a manger, this Word made flesh, his light will make all things visible. This is the story of the Prince of Peace.
Full of light and full of promise, journey by a virgin birth. Tell us all It was during the reign of the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus, great nephew of Julius Caesar, that a baby was born in Israel. At that time, Caesar decreed a census and an edict was issued requiring all people to register in the city of their ancestors.
It was this census that caused a young couple, Joseph, from the royal line of King David, and Mary, great with child, to undertake a journey of some days from the north country of Nazareth to the city of David.
When they reached Bethlehem, they found a stable because there was no other room. And so it was, in the most common of circumstances, that a most uncommon baby was born. They named him Jesus.
Ah, now this was a night for journeys, because in a nearby field, a fearsome angel of the Lord, joined by a mighty host of angels, announced to shepherds the birth of the baby, the Savior.
This is how you will know him. You will find him wrapped in pieces of cloth, lying in a manger. Thus, this story of journeys, begun with Caesar, the most powerful man on earth, continues with Mary and Joseph, the angels and the shepherds.
But God was not finished. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace.
This Ancient of Days, this one who existed from all eternity, whose very breath called into existence the worlds, becomes flesh, conceived in the womb of a virgin.
The word creates another Genesis, bringing morning light into darkness again. This, then, is the creation of something completely new. God as a baby, God as ransom.
Emmanuel, the Ancient of Days, newborn.
Emmanuel, Emmanuel. Mary and Joseph's journey had begun months before in the presence of an angel. Now Mary heard the words in her mind again, his voice echoing in her ears again. Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you. The voice sounded like thunder. It sounded like singing. And then her own inexplicable response, I am your servant, your servant. Let it be to me according to your word. Do you know there are moments when things are right? So right they need no explanation. The fear would come soon enough, but not now. Now Mary felt joy building inside her like a song. The Lord's Messiah, child of redemption, in her. And somehow in that growing calm in the center of her soul, she knew that Joseph would come to understand.
Joseph had not cried since he had become a man, but now anger, fear, confusion threatened to overwhelm him, and he was not embarrassed by the tears that came so often and so easily. How could he be expected to trust again? How could this have happened? He wrestled with his response. The weight of this decision pressed in on him until he was exhausted. Finally, merciful sleep. It was then that the angel came again.
So blessed, he sang my name to me. On this morning of all mornings, in my deepest place he breathes. Now a girl of lowest stature holds the wonder of his grace. In this holiest of moments, I rest in mercy's grace. I have always followed you. I need your strength.
What will they say? Perhaps I must send her away. The pain will not subside. The damage to my bridal hair must be a better way. Yet I have always followed you. I need your strength to see me through.
there are those who are instantly and instinctively know that everything otherworldly is occurring.
Kings from far off lands witness an astonishing sight in the heavens. Shepherds are awakened from a sound sleep and actually come face to face with the miraculous.
The world is waiting in solemn stillness, all creation ready to burst with praise.
And now, the Prince of Peace has finally come. The song of the angels is carried on the gentle wings of the evening.
Listen, be very still.
There,
and listen.
There off in the distance, the good news of peace on earth. Do you hear what I hear?
Set the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see?
A star, a star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite.
Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy.
Royalty in search of royalty. King seeking the king. And yes, another journey. These men of wisdom detected something new in the heavens. They soon realized they were witness to a miracle. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy and began the sojourn to the city of David and an audience with the Holy Child.
O'er mountains and valleys, it led them each night, a star of most radiant light. The wise men rejoiced as they journeyed afar to behold such a beautiful star. To behold such a beautiful star.
Find the baby at last. Yes, the star would find the baby at last.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced, rejoiced. When they saw the star, they rejoiced, rejoiced. When they saw the star, they rejoiced, rejoiced. They rejoiced with their exceeding great joy.
From the dawning of creation, peace was always the Father's plan. But Eden's garden of protection was defiled by sinful man. Cruel death and separation, the deceiver's awful creed. He consumes those he meant for living. Destroyed alone, we grieve. Then God bends down in mercy, reveals his endless grace. To pay the price of justice, sends his Son to take our place. He came in humble fashion to earthly man unknown. This baby in a manger, the heir to heaven's throne. Oh, the night of his appearing marked the dawn of our release. Highest glory in the heavens and on earth peace.
Yearning for him.
now we will offer our gifts to God through our offerings.
Sweet shrine, the everlasting.
are the words of the Savior we celebrate this day.
Peace I leave with you, may peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid.
Jesus, thank you for the gift of peace. Help us to see the world through your eyes. Listen to those in need through your ears. We ask you to give us the protection of heaven and on earth, peace.
And now may the Lord of peace himself grant you his peace, the peace of his kingdom. At all times and in all ways, under all circumstances and conditions, whatever comes, the Lord be with you all.
Full of light and gold, upon this journey by
the congregation please stand for the great Thanksgiving? The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new in the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. God fills the hungry with good things. Taste and see that the Lord is good. You may be seated. Christ given for you. Would you please grasp the hand of someone near you for the blessing? May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Holy One, we give you thanks that in this bread and cup we have feasted again on your endless love. Let that love overflow more and more in our lives, that we may be messengers to prepare your way, harvesters of justice and righteousness, and bearers of your eternal word, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
May God direct your ways in peace, make you abound in love for one another and for all, and strengthen your hearts until the coming of our Lord Jesus. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. As I remind you, we will be singing together, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Thank you.